I guess I want to make sure I talk about last game, last play, all that stuff, because I assume that's what everybody really wants to talk about. And I think it's important. It's hard coming in here on Tuesdays sometimes because we've already put it behind us to a certain extent or done the best we could and talked to our players and it's on to the next game. So I just want to kind of tell you my feelings on it, and then maybe that'll lead to any questions you guys have. You guys know I've always tried to be open and honest. First, I think I want to say this, and this is from my heart. I think some of the criticism of Coach Jones is unfair. You know, I made the call on the last play, and I'll talk about what went into the thinking on that and all those things. The thing I give this team and him specifically a lot of credit for, you know, 2 weeks ago we go to Georgia Tech. We're down 2 touchdowns in the fourth quarter of the game against a Paul Johnson coach team that rarely ever loses a game when they're up in the second half. And the players had the fortitude, the coaching staff had the calmness to help the team come back and win that game. And this week, to be down 10 points 2 different times in the fourth quarter against Florida, I thought it was a tremendous credit to Coach Jones, to the staff, and to the players specifically to battle back and put us in a position to win the game. I think it's very, very, very unfortunate. I don't know that we deserve to win the game because we made a lot of mistakes, but I don't think this team deserved to lose in the manner that it did on Saturday. Then I assume everybody's question is about the last play, and I'll just talk about that a little bit. You know, we talked, you know, we knew, certainly we're talking when we had possession of the ball as a defensive staff, well, what do you think? Okay, if we score a touchdown, here's what they're going to do. If they kick a field goal to tie the game, here's what they're going to do. As you guys may or may not know, Florida has an outstanding kicker. I mean, a guy who can kick 55, 60-yard field goals. And so when they got that first down, you know, we thought they were going to play for, you know, getting the ball in that 35 to 40-yard area and kick a long field goal. And that's still, if you watch the play, to describe the last touchdown as a Hail Mary is an inaccurate description of the play. To me, the description, I would describe it as a basketball player hitting a three-quarter court shot to win a game at the end of the game. I mean, that's what it was more like than anything. It was a fluky type play. Not apologizing, not making excuses or anything like that. Our strategy on that last play was watch them come out of the huddle. If they come out in a huddle, that's a Hail Mary type formation, call timeout and reset the defense. They did not do that. We were in I'm not going to tell you the name of the coverage, but we were in quarter half. So we had 4/3 to the 3-receiver side, and we had 3/2 to the backside. Justin Martin, Mike Abernathy, and Corte Sapp over the backside. The back blocked, so essentially became 2/1. If you actually watch the play, Felipe Franks went to his first key, wasn't there. We took away the play. We took away the play that they ran, which is the irony of the whole thing, really, right? You know, Batuli, Galdon, Mosley, and Warrior were dead on the play. Dead on the play. And then Kongbo got a little too far up the field. I thought that was something we didn't do a very good job of. We should have done a little bit better job with the pass rush, not letting him set his feet. And so he looked at one, looked at two, looked at three, started to run. And oddly, I feel as if it had been the second or third quarter of the game, he'd have just run. That's what he'd have run. But then he said, I can't run. I got to do something. And somehow, some way, he made eye contact with Cleveland. And you actually see them, Cleveland point and him point. And he just kind of was falling backwards. And I sort of wish Corte Sapp would have been a little more explosive and knocked the dog crap out of him right there. But he didn't. And he threw a dime. And, you know, the player got behind our player. And it was a disastrous ending. And it was a... It's a shame because what hurts is I don't feel bad. I feel bad for our players. I feel bad for the people in this building, and I feel bad for our fans because I would have liked to see that one go to overtime. I think that would have been a hell of a game.